All right. Well,
looks like the UPS man's been here again. What do we have? First, they missed me. I made the mistake of going somewhere and getting some lunch. But what do we have here? It's a good RX1Hs printer. This is the RH1 High Speed printer. I just got it. Got a great deal on Imaging Spectrum. I think I picked this baby up on Blowout for $450. It's new. And what's the difference? This is a photo printer, dye sublimation. What's the difference between this printer and the old one, the RX1 that's not high speed? Well, this one's high speed, that one's not. But in actuality, there is no difference, no difference whatsoever. It's the exact same printer. It's just that this one has an upgraded firmware, which shaves a couple of seconds off the printing speed, which is always appreciated. But you can't use the old paper and ink roll in this. This, you have to use the new stuff, of course. So along with this, we had to get some new media. Anyway, I'm going to unbox this thing, and I'm going to see if there actually is. I'm going to compare it to my old one upstairs that I use in my photo booth. We needed this anyway because our backup was a little Canon selfie printer. It looks like we'll probably have that for sale now. Depending. Anyway, I'm going to unbox this thing. Well, here, let's unbox it together. That came open pretty easily there. Let's see what I got here. Okay, so here's what we have. And there it is, folks. Of course, my favorite, a box in a box. I love it when I get a box in a box. And you know that, don't you? All right. Something tells me this isn't going to be quite as easy to open. I'm going to probably need both hands to get this puppy out of there. So give me just a second. And I'm definitely going to need both hands to get this puppy out of there. What do you say, Emmalou? Yeah! Whap those ears. Okay. I have now pulled the box out of the box. There you go. And this one got, I pulled that box out of that box. So apparently they got it shipped to them from somebody. They just slapped another label and sent it on down the line, which is fine. But now let's unbox our second box. It's like one of those Russian nesting dolls, the matryoshkas, I believe they're called. I think my wife has some matryoshkas laying around here somewhere. Can I get this with my fingers? Can I get it with my fingers? Can I get it with my fingers? Sorry, I'm out of frame there. Or am I going to have to go get a sharp device? You know, they don't like me playing with sharp devices. I think I might be able to get this without using any special implements of destruction. All right. We ready to view this together? Yes, I am available for operatic performances. Hey, good. I needed another one of these. Comes a USB cable. Looks like a good length. And good, I needed to put another one of those in my bag. What is it? Drivers. Hey, it's got a Windows 10 driver on there. That's pretty cool. Except my photo booth computer is Windows 7, and I'm keeping it that way. I mean, because my photo booth doesn't go on the internet. So I just print. Oh, look. They gave me the high capacity catch tray. That is something. Well, I'll just tell you. The guy at B&H told me that this printer does not come with any catch tray whatsoever. I think I bought my first printer from B&H. And they told me it came with no catch tray, period. And he told me, you know, that if I wanted a catch tray, I'd have to spend an extra $15 and get this guy right here. So I said, okay. And the guy swore on a stack of Bibles. And then I get it, and the thing comes with a catch tray. I mean, it comes with a little plastic catch tray, which is fine for my needs. I don't really need a high-capacity catch tray. Matter of fact, I don't need this high-capacity catch tray, unless there's not another catch tray that comes with it. And so I was not too pleased that I had to box this thing up and ship it back. It, you know, it didn't end up costing me anything, but my frustration, my time and effort, and you know, I didn't appreciate that. But anyway, back to this. All right. Hopefully it comes with the little plastic catch tray, too, because that's a little more compact. Okay, read me first. Okay, we'll read that later. And some other literature here. It looks like Spanish. Oh, warranty stuff. 1 year, the earlier of 1 year or 30,000 prints for 4x6. Okay. And then you got this stuff. And yeah, it talks about using that spacer there when you transport it. If you don't transport it with that spacer, you're an idiot. With a capital idiot. So anyway, there it is. There is the star of the show. Looks just like my other star of the show. It's no different. So I'm going to have to label it because I still have to use up all my old media, the slower media. But I've got to use that stuff up before I do that. And then, you know, you can take your old RX1s and update the firmware and turn those into high speed. So you know. No need to get rid of your old ones or get different media or any of that stuff. But before I do that, I've got a bunch of old media I have to use up before I can do that. So anyway, I don't want to mess around here. Certainly don't want to try and lift this beast out with one hand. So I am going to cut away here, lift this out gently. But before we do that, this little box was like sitting over there to the side. I mean, it was turned the other way. And I just thought it was a spacer, but there is something in here. I don't know what could be in there. I mean, what possibly could be in there? I mean, we've got all the components to this thing right here. So it says right there that it's an accessory from the Dai Nippon Printing Company. So I am completely baffled as to what could possibly be in here. So let's find out together. Oh, okay, yeah. Okay, this is like the spools, of course, the spools for the printer ribbon, which doesn't come with the media, of course, and then you've got your power cable. Yes, okay, I don't really need to take all that apart, but I'll take a little bit of it apart, see if there's any surprises. So that wasn't really a surprise, that's just stuff you would expect in there. And what is this over here? Here's the little catch tray, the little plastic catch tray that it comes with. So they included as a bonus the high capacity catch tray, which I don't need and I'll never use, which I'll probably sell online. And B&H sells these for $15, so if anybody wants a high capacity catch tray, I don't need this thing. I mean, is it even worth it for me to pack this thing up and sell it to someone online? I mean, it's just really not. I guess I'll have it, but I like this because it just folds up and goes right in your bag. So this makes more sense for me. You know, I don't understand why or how I would ever have any use for this. Unless it, like, falls out of a slot. You know, if you hang this outside of, you know, the case, but you know, you always got to watch that stuff because kids will try to pull the prints, drunks will try to pull the prints. You know, there's not as it's being printed, you know, as it's coming out of the machine before it cuts it. You know what? I've noticed in my years of doing events that there's not a whole lot of difference between dealing with children and dealing with drunks. Anyway, back to the printer. I'm making this video way longer than it needs to be, aren't I? All right, I'm going to pull this thing out, and we're going to have a look. All right, there it is. First glance, I don't really notice anything different at all. No, everything's exactly the same, except for one small detail, which I'm very thankful for. The label, it's got the high-speed label on it. That's a good way to tell which one it is. And I'm very thankful for them putting that on there. It's going to save me some confusion in the while I'm in the process of, you know, of finishing out my older one and migrating over to this one, then upgrading. Then I'm going to upgrade my old one to a high speed and have that as a backup. Oh, well, where the heck was that thing? That thing was what, in here? I always put that thing like in there. That's where it's supposed to go, right? Right like that. These guys had this thing kind of like over here or something. It popped. I've never had that thing move on me. That's where it's supposed to go, right there, right? If I am incorrect about this, would somebody please tell me? Because this is where I always put this insert. Because the head, I mean, the print head is right there, right? That is the print head, right? So that actually looks different. That little rubber roller right there, that looks different. I'm going to have to compare that to my old one. That could be an upgrade. But, okay, maybe it's just something I didn't notice. But, yeah, it looked like this. It looked like they had this thing stuck in here. So have I been doing this wrong? Because that. Somebody please let me know. Okay. Anyway, that is normally where I put it because I've always thought that's where it went. Is there some reason? Is that not where it goes? These are not print heads. I mean, I guess if these rollers get damaged, you know, if you hit a sudden bump, but, you know, that I always thought that was it. All right. Anyway, all looks the same. Nothing more to see here, folks. You got your paper catch tray, which you should be cleaning out regularly. Don't let that fill up. If it fills up, you know, those little paper scraps are going to back up into your printer and you're going to have some real problems. Anyway, I'm going to haul this thing upstairs and compare it side by side with the RX1 and see what other differences. Okay, guys, I am up here in my office. This is the photo booth I'm working on for an event for next weekend right now. The colors are blue and silver. And this is the office in our house here, and it's kind of a disaster area. See, I got all the stuff just kind of strewn about right now. This is just our kind of nuclear testing facility, and we got to get in there and iron out those drapes. We got some floral centerpiece going to go up there, and some little doodads there. But this is about the printer, not about that. So here is our old printer, our RX1, still. Still chugging along just fine. It's been a solid workhorse, and that's why I did not even hesitate to think about going for another one. And what I normally do is, that's our carrying case down there. I'll give you a look. I got one for this as well. A carrying case, like $80 on Amazon, or you can find it at B&H. We got ours at B&H. It was the best deal going. They had it in stock. And it's a lot better. I just cannot spend $200+ on a case for a $450 piece of equipment. I mean, come on, I'm not going to spend half as much on a case as I do on the piece of equipment. That's insanity to me. I will make my own case before I do that. Anyway, back to the printers. There's the old RX1. Here's the new RX1. And about that foam being in the wrong place, well, I put it in the right place, and it just kind of catches when you come out. So that makes me feel a little better that it probably wasn't bouncing around in transport. So got that one open. Let's go and open this one. I've got, the media tray. Let me take that ribbon off. As you see, that rubber roll that's in the new one isn't there on the old one. So that is one difference. See, well, we got that rubber roll right there. There's two rollers there, and that rubber roll there. Well, wait a minute. It might be. Hang on. Maybe I've never noticed it because it. Well, I'll have to take out the paper. Oh yeah, it's most definitely there. Okay, my bad. All right. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open up this case of media here, and I'm going to look at the differences between the old RX1 media and the new, and hope there's a real good way to differentiate the two. My understanding from what I've been told is that that little end right there, that little end cap, will be a different color on the high speed. Let's find out. I may actually need to cut that thing open. See what I got? I got a sharp-edged little file here. That'll do the job here. That looks like it did it. I'm real careful when I open this thing. I also got this media from Imaging Spectrum when I purchased the printer. Okay, that should be enough to get us where we're going here. Packing list. All right. Okay, there's the paper, nothing unusual there. And, wow, says high speed, and the plunger is not a different color. Okay, well, that means we're going to have to be very, very, very careful not to mix these up. Word on the street is you cannot use one in the other. And that definitely says high speed on the label, the HS. So that I am not happy to see. I'd really like to see a differentiator between those two. Of course, there wouldn't be any difference in the paper. But all right, I guess the only thing left to do is, my understanding is that the new printer should work with the old driver. The only thing that's different between these two is the firmware for the actual printer, and that shouldn't affect the operation. So now we're going to get to see side by side how much faster the new is from the old, and if the same driver does truly work. And we'll do a speed test for them. We'll do one, and we'll time it, then we'll do the other and time that, and see just how much faster is the high-speed RX1 over the old one. All right, let's get to it. Okay, guys, the computer's fired up. The booth is fired up. And I'm getting ready to fire up the printer. I'll show you what I got going on here, though. There we go. That's a little nicer. And I'll show you what I did here. This is my own contraption here. I built a shelf. It's a tripod speaker stand. I'm just going to put a shelf on there. Got a little leg there to make sure the shelf stays nice. Shelf comes through like that on a little L bracket. And this is an old Odyssey case, old road case. And I just tossed a screen in there. Tossed a camera in there. Nice webcam, Logitech C920. And a couple of these lights. And soft boxes off eBay and Amazon, and it's just been working gangbusters. We did make sure to get a good computer so to avoid problems with the solid state. And I cut a little hole here for all the cabling, and you know that's where the power comes in. A little from a boat store right there. That's for a marine and boat store. So you know those cables just kind of go. Go in that little door right there first, and then, you know, close it. And that little latch from hardware store, and I'm off to the races. But anyway, we're here for this printer, so let's fire this printer up here. This is the old one. Okay. That's how fast that guy came on. And we're going to do a test print here. By the way, this is the design for the prom I have coming up. Lights above 5th, Brentwood High School, 2017. That's what we're working with there. And, yeah. So let's do a test print here.
And we will, since the timer is in my phone, I'm just going to do the old fashioned one Mississippi, two Mississippi. All right. So here, let's go ahead and gauge how long it takes to print. We do four here. So one. Okay. Our second picture. And I'll take it from when this flashes, okay? One Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi, four Mississippi, five Mississippi, six Mississippi, seven Mississippi, eight Mississippi, nine Mississippi, 10 Mississippi, 11 Mississippi, 12 Mississippi, 13 Mississippi, 14 Mississippi, 15 Mississippi. All right, so we got 15 Mississippis on the old printer. So there's 15 Mississippis on that guy. So let's see. I'm going to turn off the old one, and I'm going to plug the USB and cable into this one. I don't need to film that. And then I'll fire this thing up, let it do its startup procedure and all that stuff, and then see how many Mississippis we take on the high-speed RX1, the big finish, as it were. Okay, guys. Well, we have run into a snag here. I've, as you see, the printer says it's fine. I've got the USB connected, the power connected, everything connected here. And I thought I was recording a second ago because I tried to do, my test on the high speed, but the result doesn't really require me filming that again, because what happened was absolutely nothing happened. So apparently this thing may possibly need a special driver. And if that's the case, I need to install that special driver before I can do any kind of test, which means that the things I've heard where no special drivers needed was a dirty, filthy lie. So I've tried to print my next session here. I just went in and tried to hit print because it wouldn't do it. I disconnected and reconnected the USB. It made the little boink, boink sound, which means that it's talking to itself, talking, and got a big fat zilcho. So, tell you what, I will hook up the old printer and clear out those last two prints. I'm guessing when I hook up the old one, it will print them. And then I'm going to go and see if I can figure out what's going on. So far, that was a disappointment. We'll see how this all shakes out. Yep, just as I suspected, the second I plugged the old printer back in, here comes the prints. From the two things I put in the print queue, there they come right there. It should be printing a second one right now. Sure enough, so this new one apparently needs a driver. So off I go to get a driver. At least I hope that's the issue. Good morning, Evan. Okay, so here I am on DNP's website looking at the drivers. And, well, it looks like it's all the same driver. I can't really focus in on my phone. But down here it says new driver for RX1 and DSRX1HS. Complete size 200 megabytes. There's a Windows 7, which is what I'm running up there because my photo booth does not go onto the internet. 32 and 64-bit. Well, That should do it. That's both of them. So why don't I go for that? And there we go. I'm downloading it, and I'll put it on a thumb drive and stick it over there on the photo booth computer, and we'll see what happens. Okay, so here I am over on my Windows 7 computer, and I'm going to install this driver. Because it does say HS, so something's changed there, because before it, of course, wouldn't have said HS back a couple years ago, because it didn't exist a couple years ago. So maybe one driver will control them both. I just need to install the new driver. So I'm going to do that. And okay, well, I've installed my driver. I just guessed at 64-bit. I'm
pretty sure that's what I'm running. So now I'm gonna try to print something. I'm not gonna do another session here. I'm just gonna go here into my prints folder. Someday my prints will come. Blah 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 blah. And we'll just print something. Go up here and hit print and see what happens. See if it behaves. And I got nothing, honey. I got Jack Doodly Squat. All right. Back to the... Okay, so I got off the phone with Imaging Spectrum to see, I wasn't able to get a hold of the tech guy just yet. He's kind of stacked up with orders, but I was able to verify that the new media for the high speed is supposed to have a special mark on it, on the little plunger on the end of the ink roll, that tells you, that indicates that it's high speed. Now, I didn't personally notice any difference between the high speed package, the plunger on the end, and the old one. They say this should have a gray stripe on it. And if I'm recalling correctly, this didn't, which means it looks like there was most likely a mix up in the media, and they sent me media for the old RX1. And if that is the case, then I have to just return it to Imaging Spectrum. And I already talked to them, and I'm going to do one more look at it when I get home to make sure. But I'm guessing that they just sent me the wrong media. So that's one thing you're going to have to watch out for. And don't let yourself get too low on media. That's always the cardinal rule in the photo booth business. Don't let yourself get into emergency mode on your media. Ever, ever, ever. Make sure, you're well-stocked. Wait till you're down. You make sure you can handle a few jobs before you need it. So anyway, that's where I'm at right now. I'll have another look at it when I get back to the office. Right now, I'm at the transmission shop. And it doesn't look like I've got a major problem with my transmission, but I wanted to have it looked at. So anyway, fun. Okay, so now we're back in the laboratory here, looking at this. And this is the new printer. And as you can see, it does indeed have a gray insert on the end. That is the differentiator. Talked to the guy at Imaging Spectrum. The tech called me back. And you see on the old one, it's just solid yellow. So, therefore, the media is not the issue. I was really hoping that was the issue, because that would make life a whole lot easier now, wouldn't it? So, anyway, I'm going to call the tech back and see what's going on. Okay, I just got off the phone with Imaging Spectrum, and the guy Herb over there was nice enough to walk me through. And so there was nothing wrong with anything they sent me. It's just that this new printer behaves a little different from the old printer. The old printer, we could load the media with the printer off and then turn it on, and it's all ready to go. It had a little stopper there. But when I loaded the media in the new one, there was no little stopper there for the paper to tell me when it's loaded. So apparently that's been some sort of new feature since I bought my old unit. So you have to load the media with the printer on. Isn't it funny how it's always sometimes just the stupidest, dumbest little things, but you'd never think of. But anyway, I have my supermodel Evan here, so he is actually going to pose. So we had 5 Mississippis on the old one. We're going to see how many Mississippis we get on the new one. Oh, by the way, here's side-by-side comparison of the prints from the old. And here's the one that the high speed just printed out. And here's the one from my old printer. So what are the only difference I could notice is extremely subtle. One came out slightly, ever so slightly darker than the other. So anyway, we are going to, Evan, you ready? And I'm going to count Mississippi's once he's done with his last pose, and we'll see if this new one beat, how far it beats 15 Mississippi's. Here we go. There's his first pose.
Comes his second pose. And, you know, I didn't go into the settings of the photo booth software. So hopefully that won't cause me a hiccup here in my test. Three. Hopefully it'll just work. Should just work, I'm hoping. Okay. Two. One Mississippi. Two Mississippi. Three Mississippi. Four Mississippi. Five Mississippi. Six Mississippi. Seven Mississippi. Eight Mississippi. Nine Mississippi. 10 Mississippi, 11 Mississippi. Okay, well, the orientation is wrong. I've got to go set that up in the software. So it shaved 4 seconds off the print time. A notable improvement. Wouldn't you say, Evan? Exactly. My thoughts exactly. That's what I feel like right now. I feel like taking a silly string break somewhere. Anyway, this is Neil Smith.
And Evan Smith.
And Evan Smith, of course.
At DandyDJ.com.
Dandy DJ and Photo Booth. If it deserves to be celebrated, it deserves to be dandy. I'm going to have to go set that up, but that's not a big deal. I just changed the orientation in the program, and we'll be good to go. Anyway, you guys stay dandy now. What's there to review about the RX1 HS? I mean, it works. It's great. Shaves 4 seconds off your time from the old one. On a scale from 1 to 10, I got to give it a 10. Well, I mean, that's my fault right there. But, yeah, I'll give it a 10. Just there's some things you need to know about. And, load the paper and ink with the unit on. Okay? Make sure to have that little gray cap on the end of your media. Otherwise, you've... And there you go. Anyway, take it easy. Okay, so a quick little addendum here. When I went to plug back in my old printer, now that one wouldn't print. Well, I figured it out. The drivers, despite being stated that they're the same, they're not the same. In other words, I can't just unplug one, plug one in the other. So each printer has its own deal. So I had to just set them up as two different printers. And that's all I had to do. My old one is now RX1 in the drop down menu. The new one is RX1 copy in the drop down menu. So that's why you figure these things out in your testing lab before you go on a job. And so glad I put it through the paces. Now I just got to let my wife, who runs the booth, know about this and, you know, show her what's going on, so that she does not run into this issue in the field. And if she does have to go and grab the backup printer, which until we use all our old media, the backup printer is going to be the high speed. And then once we've used all our old media, the high speed will become our number one printer, and our old printer will then become the backup, and I'll update that firmware to make it high speed. That's another video for another time. But anyway, just wanted to add that on there to help out anyone who might be dealing with this thing where they have an old RX1 and they just got a new RX1. They want to be using them both. They're both not called the same printer. So you got to set them up as two different printers in the queue. Okay, there you go. Hope that was helpful. Neil Smith, Dandy DJ, and Photo Booth. Hey, buy my book or check it out. My new book is called Pick a Perfect Wedding DJ. My last book before this one was called The Wedding DJ Bible. You can find it on Amazon or just go to my website, dandydj.com. Check you later.